welcome. Saturday. Hi, welcome. Hi everyone, welcome. I'm Sophia. If you don't know me, I am a Pilates instructor and a personal trainer based out here in California. Thank you so much to Zarely for having me this morning. I'm really looking forward to teaching you all, training you all. We're going to do quite a dynamic Pilates workout, kind of intermediate advanced level. So get ready to work your body. You just need a mat, maybe some water, a space in your home, wherever you are. And yeah, we'll get going in like a minute. I'm just gonna give it one more minute or so just to make sure anyone that wants to join can join live. Hi everyone, welcome. Hi. Hi, hi, hi. Hope you're all feeling good and healthy. I'm gonna let today's session just flow. We're just going to move for the whole time. So if you have any injuries or anything with your body that's just niggling today, please take care. Obviously these virtual workouts are amazing that we can all connect like this, but obviously I can't see you, so I can't keep an eye on your form. So just take accountability for your own body. If you need to make anything less intense, please do. If you want to push yourself more, go for it, make it your workout. I'm just here to kind of guide you. Hi, welcome everyone, I'm Sophia, hi. We're gonna start in about 30 seconds, a minute. So just make sure you've got a mat, a space, some water. Hi, 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 welcome, hi everyone. Okay, I think we are going to get started. So hi to anyone that has just joined. I'm Sophia. Thank you, Zarely, for having me, taking over your page this morning. We are going to do a dynamic Pilates workout. So find your space and take your mat if you have a mat. And we are going to start standing. So find your space. Good. So towards the back of your mat. And we're just going to start by rolling down and moving our spine. Let me know if you can hear me. Let me know if there's any issues. I'll just pop and check the screen in a minute so you can let me know if there are any issues. Everyone looking good. Hi, hi, hi. Welcome. Welcome, welcome. We are going to start. So take your space, take your mat. Welcome, everyone. Hi. Cool. Let's start moving our bodies. So standing towards the back of your mat, take a lovely big breath in and breathe out. Before we do anything, we get our breathing going, guys, so I'm going to face you. Breathe in, just breathe, feel your whole ribcage expanding, nice deep ribcage, 360 ribcage breath. Breathing out, feeling that ribcage closing, drawing back together, scooping back, finding those deep abdominals of your core. Our powerhouse, breathe in. Breathing out, everything's wrapping in, drawing your belly back towards your spine. Breathe in through your nose and breathing out through your mouth. Using that out breath to feel that corset feeling. Everything's wrapping in and drawing back. We're connecting back to those deep abdominals of our core. They're going to control the rest of our movement for the rest of the session. Last couple of breaths here. Just connect to your body. Just take this breathing. Take this moment with your breathing to really connect mind to body. Notice how you're feeling this morning or this evening if you're back in the UK. We're all over the world, connecting virtually. How wonderful is this? Breathing in, breathing out. Notice how you're feeling. Check in with yourself. Last couple of big breaths here. On your next out breath, release those arms. Stand towards the back of your mat. Feet are hip width apart. Breathe in, breathe out. We're just gonna roll down through the spine. One vertebrae at a time. When you reach the bottom of your roll down, breathe in, breathe out. Let's roll back up. Let's restack our spine. I want you guys to tune in with your spine. Let's take a lovely big reach up at the top. Breathe in. And breathe out. Rolling down, chin to chest. Top of the spine.
middle spine, lower spine, pelvis is the last thing to release on top of the thigh bones. Breathe in at the bottom, breathe out, rolling back up. Check in with your spine, how is it feeling today?
Get it moving, one vertebra at a time. Mobilizing the spine.
Maybe softly bend your knees if you find that you are really easily going into that hyperextension of the legs, guys. Something I do very easily, I'm sure lots of you do. So a little soft bend to the knees can help you focus more on the spinal mobility.
Last couple of roll downs.
Weight staying centered. Smoothly moving. Nice big in breath, breathe out, roll back up. Good, we're gonna walk it out to our downward dog or our flat back elephant on this next one, guys.
Breathe in and breathe out. Tuck your chin to your chest.
Find the floor, walk it out.
Let's find that down dog, flat back elephant in Pilates.
Let's just take a few walks through the feet. Breathe in, keep it smooth. Just walk it out, find that calf stretch, that gentle hamstring stretch. Scoop up through the belly. Press through the pads of the fingers, find that connection to the floor. Almost feel like someone's lifting you up through the back of your hips. You're trying to find that length through your spine. Good, both heels press towards the floor. We're gonna curve the spine, scoop through the tummy, curve through the spine. And then lengthen back into the flat back. So you're rolling the pelvis under, think of hip bones to lower ribs, scoop through the tummy, curve through the spine. The weight will slightly shift forward. And then lengthening back, sit bones releasing back into that flat back. This is our curved back elephant, round back elephant, into our flat back elephant. And use your breath, just find your breath. How is your breath syncing with your movement? Keeping it smooth. Last two, scoop and curve, release and lengthen. Feeling that wonderful stretch all the way through the spine, gently through the back of the legs. And let's hold this last flat back, just two breaths here. Nice deep belly scoop. Lifting the heels, we're gonna roll forward into a plank. Feel free to release the knees down into a knee hover if you need to. Two breaths here, push the floor away, press through the fingers. Engage the glutes, engage the deep abdominals. And you're gonna draw one knee in at a time, find your four-point kneeling tabletop. Readjust if you need to, rest under shoulders, knees under hips, cat cow. Roll the pelvis under, scoop into the tummy, curling all the way through the spine. Lengthen tailbone away from head into that gentle extended cat.
Find your flow here, guys, breathing out, scoop, curve.
Draw the tummy up, navel up the spine, push the floor away, separate the shoulder blades. Give a nice stretch through that upper mid-back area. And then gentle extension all the way from the sit bones to the chest here.
Careful we don't overextend to our lower backs here. There's probably lots of loose lumbar spines here, so take care of that overextension in the lower back.
If you feel that kind of compression, you know you've overextended a little bit.
Last two.
Breathing, flowing with your movement.
Last one, guys. Let's find our neutral tabletop back. Let's rotate our spine. Let's get that thoracic rotation going. Breathe in, pick the right hand up, bend the left elbow. Keep the hips square and high, scoop through the tummy. You're focusing your rotation in the mid-spine thoracic. And then we're gonna open up, reach the right fingertips to the sky. And again, breathing out, bending the left elbow. Twisting the spine, reaching to the side of your room. Keep the hips high, keep scooping up through the abdominals. Keep this really smooth, no sudden movements, especially if you're feeling a little bit stiff in the thoracic spine, in that mid area of your spine. Hips staying square. Try not to let your weight shift from side to side. Let's pop that right arm down. Same thing on the second side, guys. Pick up your left hand, bend your right elbow. Twisting and reaching to the right side of your room. Opening up, reach the left fingertips to the ceiling. Open through the chest. Lovely expansion, and again, breathing out. Breathing in, breathing out. And again, breathing out. Threading the needle. for our thoracic rotation. Last one. Breathing out, twist, reach. Breathing in, breathing out, last open up. And then we're gonna pop that left hand back down. Good, guys. We're gonna stretch our right leg and our left arm. Nice neutral lower back. Make sure we haven't overextended and arched, overextended into that lower back. Lift the navel up to spine, neutral lower back, glutes engaged, hips are square. Let's draw the knee and elbow in, curve the spine, scoop to the tummy, and then extend back away. Breathing out, elbow and knee come into the center, scoop through the tummy, curve through the spine, lengthen away in neutral spine. Breathing out, breathing in, breathing out. This is three. Try not to overlift that right leg at the expense of your lower back. Find the glute engagement, find the hamstring engagement, find that deep belly connection. Don't overextend into your lower back. And seven. Keep breathing. Make sure the leg's in line with the hip. Last two. And last one. And hold, lower, slide back in. Second side. So we're gonna slide the left leg and the right arm away, lengthen and lift. Turn the palm inwards. Make sure you start nice and square and neutral, hip to the mat. Neutral lower back, so they don't wanna see this. Lift, neutral lower back, glutes engaged. Knee and elbow coming in. Scoop through the tummy, curve through the back. Lengthen away. So make sure your left hip bone stays facing into your mat the whole time. Don't let it open up to the side of your room. Move at a pace that you can control the stability here. So you don't have to be with me. You might be slower, you might be faster. Keep breathing, sync your breath with your movement. And five. It's like a little contraction when the knee and elbow come in. Think hips to ribs, scooping. And then tabletop neutral spine here. And the last two. Last one. Lengthen, lower, slide back in. Good, let's take a little back release. Feet together, knees nice and wide. Sit back onto those heels. And just take a few lovely deep breaths with me there, guys. Take this moment just to breathe deep into your rib cage, all the way into your back. Focus your breath all the way around into your back for me. In through the nose and out through the mouth. Really expand that 360 breath all the way into the back. Getting in between all the ribs. Fully activating our muscles involved in our breathing and core. With that lovely full breath, last big breath. And then just roll up, restack that spine. Good, we're gonna come to a seated position, guys. So sitting on your, nice and tall on your sit bones. Knees are bent, feet are flat on the floor, hip width apart. Let's take the arms out to the side. Let's find our C curve. So roll the pelvis underneath you, think hips to ribs. Scoop through the tummy, curve through the back. Let's take the arms into this kind of elongated first position. And then breathe in, back on top of those sit bones, arms just open up. Breathing out, scoop, C curve. Breathe in, back into that nice tall lifted spine. Breathing out, scoop. Breathing in, lengthen. So think of that contraction, lower ribs to hips, closing the ribs. And then lengthen right back on top of those sit bones without popping the ribs. Nice strong out breath here. In breath to lengthen. Someone's lifting you through the crown of the head, but you're not overextending the back, you're not popping the ribs. And two more here. And last one here. We're going to add a rotation, we're going to add a twist, we're going to wake up those obliques. Find that C curve, find that scoop, roll the pelvis under, hips to ribs. Shoulders are down, open through the collarbones. Breathe out, twist. To one side, little knee lift. Breathe in through the center, foot goes down. Breathe out, twist. Little knee lift. Breathe in through the center. Alternating your sides. Squeeze. squeezing to the side of the waist. Keep this scoop to the tummy, so keep the little contraction the whole time. Ribs to hips. And then you're adding that rotation. Squeezing into the obliques. Keep the shoulders down, keep the collarbones open, elbows lifted, shoulders down. Nice strong out breath with each twist. Squeezing into the obliques. Take four more. Keep it smooth. Three. Good, guys. Last two. Last one. Good, we're going to come out of that C-curve. Make sure you've got lots of mat behind you. Stretch the legs all the way away from you. Roll the pelvis under, find that scoop, find that contraction, send the sit bones forward. Get the lower back onto your mat first. We're coming down to our mat, one section of our spine at a time. Middle back, upper back, neck, head. Let's take a few full roll-ups. Breathe in, reach behind, breathe out, reach. Chin to chest, smoothly scooping up. Shoulders are over hips, lengthen and lift. Let's flex the feet, let's reach forward, fold. And then roll back up to a nice tall neutral spine. And again, just keep this flowing, find your own pace. Don't worry if we're not together. Nice and smooth as you roll down. A little bit of momentum on the way up, but still keep it scoop smooth. Keep that, find that scoop to the tummy, curve through the back. Nice tall spine, lengthen, lift, forward, fold. We're gonna take two more. The slower you can go down, the more strength it's going to be. We're really scooping deep into those deep abdominals. It's like someone's pulling from behind on your belly button. Ribs are closing. Really connecting back to those transverse abdominals, those deep abdominals. Lift. And the next one, guys, we're going to roll down and we're going to stay down on our mats. I'm going to shimmy forward just a little bit so I've got lots of space. Roll down. Let's go down as slow as we can, okay? Keep the breath flowing. Find the very, very bottom of your back on the mat. That sacral area, sacrum area. Then find the lower back. Ribs to hips, middle back, upper back, shoulders. All the way down. Oh, let's just take two big breaths here. Just find yourself on your mat. Just feel that heaviness, that connection. Good, let's bend the knees. Just make sure I'm in. Good shot. Good, so bend the knees, feet are hip width apart. Knees are right under your hip joints. Make sure that you've got that alignment there so that we can really keep the alignment good so that our muscles can activate correctly. Breathing in, breathing out. Press your lower back into your mat, hips to ribs. Engaging through the center, lift the hips, peeling all the way up towards your shoulders. Let's breathe in, reach behind us. Let's breathe out, reach through the fingertips and roll down through the spine. Let's take a few really plain glute bridges or spine curls. Again, focusing on that mobility of the spine. So breathing out, press through the heels, lift the hips, peeling up through the spine one section at a time, all the way up to the shoulders, into that full shoulder bridge. We breathe in, we reach behind us. Breathe out, really reach the back of your room, guys, as you peel down, okay? It's like someone's pulling you through your fingertips and you're really trying to get one vertebrae down at a time. Close those ribs. I'm a little bit ribby. Ex-dancer in me. Close those ribs. Your pelvis is the last thing to hit. Make sure you find your neutral lower back, guys, when you come all the way down, okay? Neutral. Don't stay in that imprint. Not good for your lower back. We want to try and find that neutral lower spine, the natural position of our lower spine, where our muscles can be the most balanced and work the most efficiently. Breathing out, peeling down, melt through your breastbones, get the very top of your spine down, then your middle spine, lower spine, pelvis. Breathe into lower. Two more completely plain before we add on. Make sure those knees are staying parallel, have an awareness of those adductors, those inside thighs. Pressing through the heels, squeezing those glutes. Let's start really switching on our glute muscles. We've got more glute work to come. Prepare yourself. Let's move the heels nice and close in towards our butt, guys. Let's roll up to that full shoulder bridge and stay there. Let's take our hands into our shoulder drop position. Palms facing each other. We're gonna lift the heels and lower. Breathe in to lift, breathe out to lower. Pelvis stays level.
as you lower your heels, squeeze deep into those glutes. It's almost like you're lifting your hips a little bit higher, so long as you don't feel any impact in the lower back. The corset's on nice and tight, the ribs are closed. As you lower the heels, breathe out and scoop belly down to spine. I kind of like that feeling of oppositional pull. So my heels are lowering, my hips are lifting, the corset's tightening, I'm scooping deeper down into my deep abdominals. Lift those heels, let's hold the lift. You lower the hips just a couple of inches, you re-squeeze back up. Lower and squeeze. Lower and squeeze. We go eight. And six. And five. Really small, guys. Just squeezing deep into the glutes. Three. Knees are staying in line with the hips. Adductors are on. Last one. Let's roll down nice and slowly. Reach your fingertips up to the ceiling so your shoulder blades will glide around your rib cage here. And really peel one vertebrae down at a time. Scoop to your tummy, curve through your back. Release. Whew, good. Into a little bit of single leg glute work. Okay, so we're now going to focus on keeping that pelvis really level, really neutral. No dipping on one side as we work the single leg. So you need more connection to that core for this. Think of that corset even tighter, navel down to spine. Heels nice and close into your butt, let's roll up. Let's take a set of knee marches. So breathing out, one knee lifts. Breathe in, lower back to the floor. Alternate legs, the knee that lifts, just make sure that side of your pelvis does not drop down. Feel that connection in the glute, in the core, before you lift. Don't try and add it on, don't try and wing it. I can't see you guys, but I know all the little cheats from years of teaching. But I can only imagine you guys are super strong. Good, you can have the hands on the hips here to help, make sure the pelvis is not moving. And we'll go four. And three. And two. And one. Breathe in. Breathe out, roll down. We've got one more variation for some single leg glute work. We're gonna roll back up. So having both feet on the floor to start with, let's roll back up to that glute bridge one more time. Let's lift our right leg to the ceiling, nice and straight. We flex the right foot, the leg lowers in line with the left thigh. Point the right foot, lift. Breathe out to lower. Breathe in to lift. Keep pushing the floor away, keep lifting through that supporting glute. Core is nice and tight, and three. And four, let's get some movement at the ankles and the feet now. Five. Make sure your right side of your pelvis is dropping. And eight, last two. And let's just finish off that left glute, little drop and lift, little pulses, reaching your toe to the ceiling. Last two. And roll down. Woo, lovely. I'm going to give you a mid-session glute stretch on the left side. So the left foot goes over the right thigh, hands behind the back of that thigh. Interlock the fingers, draw towards you, push that left knee open, breathe. So stretching out the glute that's just been working on that single side, guys. Breathe into it. We'll do a longer stretch at the end. So just a little one just to make sure we don't cramp up. Last two big breaths there. And release, good. Foot goes back to the floor, same thing on your second side. So start with your heels nice and close in towards your bum. Breathe in, breathe out, rolling up and finding your glute bridge. So now you're gonna take your left leg into the air, nice and straight, point the foot, and then we lower the leg and flex the foot, lift the leg and point the foot. Breathe out to lower. So make sure this left side of the pelvis isn't dropping down, nice and level. Breathe out. You can have a hand there if that helps. Keep pushing the floor away, lifting the hips deep into that single glute on the right side. Ribs are closed. Tummy, navel down to spine, corset's on. And five. And six. Nice straight leg if you can. And seven. And eight. Good, point the foot to the ceiling, lower the hips, breathe, squeeze. Little pulses to finish. Make sure that right knee is in staying in line with the right hip joint, guys. So you want to be aware of the right inside thigh. And squeeze. We've got 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, lower down. Woo. And then you get a little mid-session stretch on that second side. So the right foot goes over the left thigh. Loop the hands behind the back of the thigh into what the fingers draw towards you. Push this right knee open. And breathe into that glute that you have just been working. Good work, guys, lovely. Gonna switch it back to the core now. So just take 2 or 3 more deep breaths there in that stretch. Grab a little bit of water if you need it. We've got a little core sequence before we change position. One more big breath there. Good, I'm just gonna take a little hug of the knees into the chest. I'm just gonna take a little kind of roll around on the back of my pelvis, lower back. Join me if that feels good. If you're still in your glute stretch, just enjoy that. Just having a little massage through that lower back, sacrum lower back area. Good, and then we're gonna find our feet back onto the floor. So neutral lower back, guys, if you can. So no pressing of the lower back into the mat. Let's work in that neutral. So we try and find that natural anatomy of our spine to let our lower back muscles be where they need to be. Find your double knee fold tabletop. Starting nice and simple, the exercises will get more difficult, don't worry. Breathe out, stretch that opposite arm to leg. I'm gonna get you to flex your feet. Gonna feel weird for lots of you dancers. Let's flex those feet. Let's get the dorsiflexion working. Breathing out, breathing in. Starting nice and simple. Make sure that lower back's staying nice and neutral. Make sure the ribs aren't popping. Ribs are staying close together. You're drawing your tummy down to your spine. I like to think of a corset wrapped around, gently tightening as I take the exercise, as I do the exertion of the exercise. I also think of softening my breastbone. We don't talk about that a lot in core work, but it's very common for a lot of us to start taking the tension up here, especially if we're trying to do the more advanced work. Soften through that sternum, through that breastbone, soften through the ribs. Find that feeling of drawing deep down into those deep transverse abdominals. Good, and this is the time you can think about it in the more simple exercises so that it becomes completely natural in the more advanced ones. We're gonna glue the legs together. Let's point those feet, palms face forward. Breathe out, stretch both arms and legs. Breathe in, take a curl up as the knees come in. So breathe out, stretch, double leg stretch, arm stretch. Breathe in, breathe out. Find your own breath on this. See what's happening naturally with your breath. I don't want to dictate it on this one. See how you want to breathe, at what point of the exercise. Think about it, let it help you control. We're just peeling up as the knees come in, ribs to hips. And we've got 5. And 4, make sure you keep a gap between the chin and your chest as you curl up so you don't overflex the neck. 3. Reaching forward, and last 2. We're gonna hold this last one, guys. Hold, hold, hold. You're gonna take hold of the right knee and the right shin and stretch the left leg away from you. And we swap, draw the left knee into the chest with the left hand and the right hand, and the opposite leg stretches. And breathing. I'm gonna let you hear my breath here. I want it to be a nice dynamic breath. And change, and change. Let's stretch those legs, let's point the feet. We're gonna go 8, and 6, and 4, and 3, and 2. Keeping that curl up, keeping that contraction, ribs to hips. And we're gonna lower down, have a breather. We have one more exercise here, guys. Breathe, reset. We're moving into the straight leg scissor, if you know it. Straight leg scissor. Last one for the core before we roll over. So, take your double knee fold. Let's stretch the legs to the ceiling. Let's rotate the legs out, find that lovely turnout. Breathe in, reach behind you. Breathe out, reach forward, curl up, ribs to hips. Keep the gap between the chin and the chest, guys. Take hold of the back of the right leg. One hand can be on the calf, one hand can go behind the hamstring. Don't pull the knee, other leg lowers. We change. We change. Find your speed. It could be a little bit slower. It could be nice and fast. Keep the color, keep the contraction. Use this lovely dynamic power breath. And five. And three. And one. Hold if you can. One last lower if you can. Last breath. Parallel. Knees come in. Rest. Oh, well done, guys. Take a breather. Lovely. I'm just going to give you a lovely spinal rotation before we change position. Take your pelvis, knees and feet over to one side. Make this whatever your body wants. Just find a rotational twist that feels good for your back. Your knees might be bent. You might stretch your legs out. You might bind if you like to bind the legs. So that little bit of extra traction. Breathe into it. Doesn't matter which side you're on. Pick a side. Find that lovely rotational stretch for your back. Unbind if you bound the legs through the center. Find that on your second side for me. Oh, it's quite warm here. Quite a hot day here in California. Getting the sweat on, it's good. Good Saturday workout. We're gonna move into a little bit of back work next. Just take a few more breaths here. Don't think about that yet. Just take two or three lovely more deep breaths here. Find that rotation through your spine. Last big breath. Good, back to the center. Hug your knees in. We're gonna roll up like a ball. Curve your spine, hold the shins, and roll all the way up to sitting. Good. Let's take one forward, fold up, reach over, couple of breaths there. And rolling up. Lovely, guys. We're gonna come onto our tummy, take a little bit of back work. So, head towards the front of your mat. Take a little bit of water if you need it. I'm just gonna have a little sip. So head towards the front of your mat, the top of your mat. Let's just take a nice cobra stretch to start with. So legs are wider than hip width, rotate the legs out, gently extend through the front of the hips, bend those elbows. Forearms flat on the floor, wider than shoulder width. Find a height that works for you, just above shoulder height for me. Lift your tummy up off the mat, tummy and navel up to spine. Roll the nose along, press through the floor. Shoulder blades slide down and in. Lengthen and lift. All the way up if it feels good. Take a baby prep one if you need to. Releasing back down. Just take a few cobra extensions in your own time, guys. Make sure you've got that strong, deep abdominal connection so we don't compress and overextend into our lower back. Really easy thing to do when you're very mobile. So if you can see me, it'd be quite easy for me to be here. I don't know if you can see my lower back. Hanging out in my very flexible lower back here, lumbar. I'm not gonna do that. I can feel the compression. It feels horrid. I'm gonna hurt my back. I'm gonna push the floor away. I'm gonna think of moving my pubic bone to my belly button or hips to ribs and lift. Someone's lifting me through the crown of my head. I'm growing, I'm lifting out of my spine, open collarbones. And then lowering back down again, thinking of lengthening my spine as I lower. So it's a lovely lengthened extension of the spine. It's not a back bend. It's not a back bend. You're super flexy, very mobile. Just be aware of that. Spread all your fingers, press through the fingertips. You want to feel that you're lifting out of your shoulder joints. So you've got active shoulder girdle. Last one. And if you can't get that lift in the full extension, you don't go all the way up. And that might be different on different days. It might depend on any injuries, how warm you are. So many factors that affect how our body feels every day. As you all know. Good. We're going to stretch our arms away. Palms face in, so we're in like a star position. Palms are facing in, just wider than shoulder width with our arms. Let's lift the tummy up to spine, navel up to spine, lengthen and lift the head, neck, upper, just to the mid-spine, guys, just to the mid-spine, okay? Shoulder blades are sliding down. From there, we lift the right leg, we lift the left leg, and then we're gonna squeeze the legs together, pointing the feet, squeeze. Breathe out as you squeeze. Squeeze those inside thighs together, draw the pelvic floor muscles up. Closing the corset, ribs, even though we're on our tummy, you need to think even more. Ribs closing, navel up to spine. Nice out breath with each beat. Draw the shoulder blades down, long back of the neck. And we beat for 5. And 4. And 3. And 2. Squeezing those glutes. And 1. And we lower down. And then we take 5 simple lifts. Breathe out. Breathe in. So it's much lower than your full cobra. Think that someone is lifting you through the crown of your head forward, pulling you forward through the crown of your head, and then pulling you through the tips of your toes. So you're really long. You've got that lovely length through the front of the hips. We're not compressing into our lumbar, last one. And lower. Good, we're gonna take a lovely back stretch. So feet together, knees nice and wide. Come and sit back into your child's pose, rest position. Your hands can be wherever you want. I love to stretch them out so I get that lovely length. Take a few lovely deep breaths with me there, guys. And 4 more big breaths. Last 2 big breaths. And then rolling up through your spine. Good. We're going to come back into our plank position. We're taking a little sip of water, grab some if you need some. So we're coming back into our plank position. So finding your 4-point kneeling. And then bringing 1 foot back, take the weight on the ball of the foot. Already engaging, ribs are closing, corsets on, navel up to spine. Spread the fingertips, press through the fingers. With the shoulder girdle, make sure we're not dropping down here. We want to press away and lift, okay, into neutral. Don't overpress, don't protract, just finding that neutral, that lifted neutral. Stretch that second leg. Pelvis in line with the spine, squeeze the glutes, engage the core, pelvic floor up. We lift the right leg, flex the foot. We shift our weight forward and point the right foot. We shift the weight back and flex. Point as you shift forward, flex as you shift back. And 3. Nothing's moving the lower back. Keeping your plank nice and neutral. And 6. And 8. And 9. And 10. Right foot goes back, lifts up through the back of the hips. Find your downward dog or your flat back elephant. Do whatever your body wants here. Walk through the feet. Hold the heels down and breathe. Whichever feels best for your body. And just take 2 more big breaths there. And then we're going to roll back into our plank and take that on the second side. So lift the heels, roll forward into your plank. Shoulders over wrist joints. Hips are square, pelvis in line with spine. Ribs are closed, lift the left foot. Shift the weight forward, point that left foot. Shift the weight back, flex. Point to shift forward, flex to shift back. Breathing however feels useful. I breathe out as I shift forward, breathe in as I shift back. To 10, 7. Last 2. And lower. Good. Last downward dog. I'm just going to walk it out. It feels really good for me right now. I'm imagining someone lifting me up through the back of my hips. So it's quite easy for me to shift my weight back here and overextend into my shoulders. I'm going to bring my weight slightly further forward. I'm going to press through all of the fingertips. And I'm going to imagine someone lifting me through the back of my hips. So I almost get that space in my lower back area, where I'm super mobile, so I tend to get a lot of tightness and a bit lankiness. Good, we're gonna walk the hands back to the feet. We're just gonna have a few breaths over our legs. So this can be whatever you want. Just hold the opposite elbows. Shift, just have a little release. You could hold the back of the legs and have a really active stretch here if you want. You could bend and stretch. Just do whatever your body wants. Tune into it, just do what it needs, what it wants. Couple more breaths. And then release the arms, roll up, re-stack that spine for me. Pelvis on top of the thigh bones, rebuild your lumbar, your middle, thoracic, cervical, neck, head. Good guys, we're gonna take a lunge sequence before we work our medial glutes and our hip stability muscles. You're getting there, you're doing so well. It's a hot one here, I don't know about where you guys are. Okay, so come to the front of your mat. Front of your mat. Okay, we're going to stretch those hips and those inside thighs adductors. So we're going to take our left leg back and
find a full rose lunge. Frame the front foot with your hands. Let's lower that left knee down to start with. Let's reach forward. Let's reach both hands up to the ceiling and breathe here. Try and close your ribs. If you can see my lower back here, I don't want you to be here, arching the back, popping the ribs. Think of hips to ribs, close the ribs, hips to square, and breathe, lift. Coming out of that, let's frame that right foot with both our hands, tuck your back toes under, press, stretch that left leg, full runner's lunge. You're gonna leave the left hand on the floor, you're gonna reach the right fingertips up to the ceiling, twist your spine, breathe there. Sink deep into your lunge, lift out that supporting shoulder, reach the ceiling, breathe. Coming out of that twist, frame the foot again. Bring the right hand to the right side of the left side of the right foot, actually, both hands at the left side. Let's come forward into a side lunge. So twist your hips and your torso to face forward. Readjust if you need to. Find this lovely stretch through your left adductor, left inside thigh. If you want to, you can let go of the floor. You can take the prayer position. You could have the hands firmly on the floor. Breathe, this is your stretch. Sinking the sit bones to the floor. Keep your right hand on the floor. You're gonna reach the left fingertips up to the ceiling. Make sure you're flexing the foot, the left foot, guys. Reach the fingertips up to the ceiling. I'm kind of pushing against my right leg to keep it open, to make sure my knees don't rock forward and my foot doesn't roll in. Coming out of that twist, both hands to the floor. Let's transition through the center. So here's your moment to have that lovely deep plie in second. Just enjoy it, do whatever your body wants. Have a little wiggle, have a hold. You could find your goddess pose if you practice yoga and you want your goddess. Just take a few moments there through the center. I'm gonna move it today, it feels really good for my hips. And then let's take that all the way over to the second side. So finding that full lateral lunge on your second side. Flex that right foot. Notice how that really affects the inside thigh of the adductor. Breathe. Opening this left knee so that the left foot's not going to pronate and roll in. Left hand stays on the floor. Reach the right fingertips up to the ceiling and breathe. And lower that right hand down. We're going to twist to the side so that you're on your full runner's lunge on your second side, guys. Your full lunge on your second side. Drop that right knee down. Reach forward. Reach up to the ceiling. Breathe there. Reaching your breastbone, your chest to the sky. Make sure you're not compressing. Sitting into that lower back. Lift, lift, lift. Like you're lifting away from your pelvis. Hips to ribs. Close your rib cage. Come back out of that. Hands frame both foot. Tuck the right toes under. Press, lift the right knee. Right hand stays on the floor. Left fingertips reach the ceiling. Adding in your thoracic rotation. And twist. Find that rotation all the way through the spine. Open through the chest. Sink the hips down. Press away from the floor. Lift out of that right shoulder joint. Don't sink into it. Press through the fingertips on the right hand. Last two breaths. Come down, find the floor with both hands. Both hands are framing that left foot. You're gonna take your left foot back so you are in your plank. Hold that plank. Good, hold that plank. We're gonna twist from side to side to find our side plank, okay? So we swivel on our feet, the left hand stays on the floor. We swivel on our feet, the right foot's in front of the left foot. We reach the right fingertips up to the ceiling. We come back through our plank. Twist to the second side. So you just twizzle on your feet. Twist on your feet, you're on the sides of your feet. Top foot is in front of the bottom foot. Nice and slow, nice and controlled. Find that side plank. Both hips face forward. Reach the fingertips up to the ceiling. Twist back through, transition back through your plank. Find your breath. And we're gonna take four more here. So you're in your side plank. Back to front plank, and side plank, back to front plank, one more to each side. Keep pressing away from the floor, lifting out of that supporting shoulder joint. Last one to your second side. breath in the plank. And then let's draw one knee in at a time. Take whatever your body needs here, guys. We've got one last little sequence to do. If you need a back stretch, have a back stretch. A child's pose, a rest position. I'm gonna take a little sip of water. Roll your shoulders, release your head, your neck. Wherever you're feeling any little bits of tension right now, just take a few rolls. Good, we have got one last little sequence, guys. We are gonna do a little bit of work for our medial glutes. Super important for helping stabilize our pelvis, protect our lower back, especially when you've got that really hypermobile lower, that lumbar. Strengthening the medial glutes is crucial. So, onto your right side, let's take a little bit of a clan sequence. I normally have a really long sequence that I like to do with clients on this, but we're gonna run out of time on the old Instagram live. So I'm cutting it short today. But I do like to do lots of sideline medial glute work. So your knees are bent, your feet are in line with your bum in line with pelvis, so alignment is really key on this one. Top hip bone over bottom hip bone, knees are in line. You can go down on this arm here underneath if it feels better for your neck. Have a little lift under the underneath side of the waist, hand on the hip. Nice and simple to start with. We just open and close that top knee into our plane clams. Nice and simple. So what I want you to try and do, guys, is try and keep this top hip flexor soft if you can. If you notice it's really, really instantly gripping, pop a thumb into it and try and just keep it from overactivating, okay? If you can, it's hard if it's dominant. And then we're gonna really try and get the medial glutes fired up. Okay, so it's that rotation out of the thigh in the hip joint, the movement that I'm sure you're all very familiar with, in that turnout position. Keep those ribs closed. So your hips should not be moving, okay? Your pelvis shouldn't be rocking back. It's purely the hip joint, the top of the thigh, in the hip joint, medial glutes working. We've got two more here. Try not to press the feet too strongly either, okay? That's another cheat. That foot should be really light on that bottom foot. So the work is all here. Same thing, we're gonna lift both the feet, keep them glued together, but the same movement. Okay, you should be able to get more range. We're looking for this nice big diamond shape in between the knees, but again, no movement at the pelvis. The pelvis stays super still, ribs are closed, gently engaging into those deep abdominals to help you keep the pelvis and lower back super stable, super still. So the work is all here. You should feel your underneath glute and hip medial glutes firing up a little bit as well. But again, don't overpress on the feet. Keep the feet nice and light. Do the work stay where it should be. And three more here. Last two. Well done, guys. Last one. Good. From here, last variation on this side. We open, stretch that top leg, rotate that top leg in, rotate it back out, bend the left knee foot to foot, close the clam. Woo. Open the clam, stretch that left leg, rotate the leg in at the hip joint, rotate it back out, bend the left knee foot to foot, lower the clam, close the clam, and again, and three. Really that rotation is at the hip joint, nothing is moving in your pelvis. Good. Oh, I'm feeling it. Rotate in. And out. So really keep your pelvis super still. This is all the medial glutes. The core is engaged to help you with that stability of the pelvis and the lower back. Last two reps. Oh, lower that foot. Knee to knee. Lower the feet down. Good. Last variation on this side. We're going to come up into a little forearm plank. So elbow is underneath the shoulder, forearm is facing forward. Plant that right hand flat into the floor. And then you're going to keep your knees bent. Move your thighs back ever so slightly so that when you lift your hips, your thighs are just forward of your pelvis. Lift on this underneath side of the waist. Lift out of this supporting shoulder and lower. And then as we lift the top leg in a parallel clamp. Okay, so we're back into that parallel now, no turn up. Push the floor away, lift. Little parallel clam lift with a side, forearm side plank prep. Okay, so we're really lifting on this underneath side, we're lifting out of this supporting shoulder. I'm gonna lift this hand up to the ceiling here. Just helps me with that feeling of lift. And breathing, make sure this hip does not lift. Okay, so don't lift that left leg higher than you can without the pelvis moving. Last two here. Last one, you're gonna hold, stretch your left leg, stretch, and tap, lift. I'm tapping my wall, and tap, and lift, and five, four, keep it parallel, guys, three, and two, and one, and lower down. Oh, you might have really felt the supporting work on the supporting leg there. Oh, lovely. Roll, release. We've got that still on our second side, and then you are done. You're nearly there. Well done. Nice deep breath. Second side. So taking it over to the first clam exercise, taking it back to that first plane clam on your second side. So make sure you're definitely on your second side. Knees are bent, feet are in line with your bum. Pelvis is stacked, hip bone over the hip bone, close the ribs. I'm going to move this way a tiny little bit more so it doesn't cut my legs out. Open that top knee and close. Breathing out, breathing in. So you're probably going to feel that you're a little bit more fatigued on this side because we did work the underneath side of the medial glutes as well. So you're going to feel a little bit more fatigued. So when you do this work regularly, make sure you switch up which side you start on. We all have our dominant side. Try not to favour it. It's actually much more beneficial if you can start on your weaker side. Good, last three here, plane. And two. These are your plane clams, last one. Same thing, but you lift both of your feet. Lift them up, make sure your pelvis hasn't shifted forward when you've done that. Top hip bone over bottom hip bone. Same movement, but with the feet lifted and glued together. Don't overpress the feet together. Keep that touch nice and light. The work is all here. You can always lift this hand up here if it makes you helps you to feel like you're lifting and not overly sinking into the floor. Or you might want it on the hip just to keep a check on that nice stable pelvis. We've got three. And two. You're nearly there, guys. You're doing so well. And last one, lower the knee to knee, lower the feet. Good, lift them back up, open again. Stretch that right leg, you rotate in, you rotate out, bend the knee foot to foot, close the clam. Open, stretch, rotate in, rotate out, bend the knee foot to foot, close the clam. Good, so you open the clam, stretch that top leg, rotate it in, rotate it out, bend the right knee foot to foot, close the clam. Ooh, feeling it. Keep those ribs from popping. Mine are just starting to flare. Close them. That corset's gently wrapped. The core is working for you here to help you maintain your pelvic stability and keep your lower back nice and stable. And keep your pelvis nice and stable so all the work can happen in the medial glutes and in the hip joint. Where are we stable? Where are we moving? Always what we like to think. Good, last one, in, out, foot to foot, and lower, good. Coming up to your forearm, elbow right underneath your shoulder joint, forearm facing forward, spread your fingers, press through the arm. Make sure you're pressing and lifting out of this supporting shoulder joint. The left is drawing down, the shoulder blade is drawing down. Lift the hips, so the knees are gonna come slightly further back on this one. You want your thighs just forward of your pelvis, close the ribs. Let's lift this top arm up. Let's lift the top leg, parallel clam lift, lower. Breathing lift, and lower, and lift. Now really lift out of the supporting shoulder joint. Hips stay square, nothing moves in the pelvis. And four, ribs are closed. And three, and two. Hold your last one, guys. Hold. Stretch, we tap. And lift, and tap, nearly there, and lift, and tap, and lift, and tap, and lift. Keep breathing. Last two. Last one. And lower. Oh, I felt that today, end of the week. Good, well done, we're gonna stretch. Just got a few minutes to stretch. So rolling down to your mat. Oh. Roll down, roll down. And then tap, finding your glute stretch, right foot over the left thigh, interlock the hands behind of that thigh, or reach for the shin, and
pull there to get a little bit more traction. I'm actually going to stretch out my lower leg and hold my foot for an even deeper stretch, and then I'm pushing my right knee out. But you are here if you need to be here with that knee bent. Keeping your bum on the floor. Do not lift the bum, it's a big cheat. Breathe. Last two big breaths here. And gently release and very carefully swap sides. And finding that on your second side, you can hold these stretches for way longer, as you know. I'm cutting them a little bit short today because I don't want Instagram Live to cut me off. But take this stretching sequence as long as you need to. You could also maybe find a pigeon pose after this session and just have a lovely release in a pigeon if you know that you've got that in your practice. Last couple of breaths wherever you are for that second side. And releasing nice and gently. We're going to stretch the hamstrings. I don't mind which side you do first. One leg goes all the way on the floor, second leg you're going to stretch it. Flexing that foot. You might have your hands behind the back of the leg. I'm going to take the foot and breathe. Try not to lift your hips, try not to tuck your pelvis. Think of that heaviness through the back of the pelvis. See if you can try and work towards a little bit of a gap between the back and the lower back, so you're finding that neutral, so that you're in a much truer stretch here. Length behind the back of that knee, lovely deep breaths. Any modifications you have, anything you want to do here, just take it, breathe. Last big breath. Bend that knee, hug that knee tight into you. Breathe out, send that leg away. Bring the other leg in. Stretching out your second leg, your second side for that hamstring stretch. Breathe into it. Please take a much longer stretch after this is finished if you need to. I'm cutting it a little bit short today. Last big breath. Hug that knee in and send it away. Breathe in, reach behind you, nice long stretch. Breathe out, roll yourself up. And find your crouch position, guys. Release over, release to the floor. Take behind the legs if you want an active stretch. Breathe in, breathe out, rebuild your spine one vertebrae at a time. Your pelvis stacks on top of your thigh bones, sit bones to the floor. Rebuild your lower spine, middle spine, top of the spine, neck, head. Let's breathe in, let's reach up. Breathe out, prayer position, hands to the chest. And thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Thank you so much, Zarely, for having me. I'm Sophia Rose, anyone that doesn't know me. Well done, all of you that stayed all the way through that. I hope you enjoyed. Have a wonderful weekend and take care of yourselves. Stay healthy. Bye, everyone. Take care.